It was always said that the aircraft was not recoverable in a spin. I'm standing here, but I haven't spun it, so I don't want to try.
Flat spins are considered unrecoverable. Aerobatic pilot Neil Spooner entered a flat spin, which is usually fatal. It was caught in dramatic detail with an onboard camera. He was one of the lucky pilots who lived to tell about it. But was it luck or skill? To find out, the Aviators UK correspondent caught up with him at his home airfield.
Neil's kindly joined us by his aircraft. So Neil, what first got you into flying?
It was my wife's fault. She bought me a trial lesson in 1988, and it all went steadily downhill from there with my private pilot's license. And I always wanted to go commercial, which I eventually did. Why the nipper? I saw Barry Smith campaign a tipsy nipper many, many years ago. It must have been about 1986. And I have to say, he put on a very, very good show with it. And I thought, well, if you can do that with sort of 1,800 cc's of Volkswagen and burning 3 gallons of petrol an hour, then really it's a very, very affordable way of doing aerobatics. And for my level of aerobatics, it really does everything. Fully inverted fuel systems, oil systems, so I can leave it upside down all day for as long as I feel happy on the strap.
You uploaded a video to YouTube of you and your aircraft doing 26 flat spins. Can you talk us through what happened?
Yeah, I have to say it caught me very much by surprise. I always thought that the flat spin was the province of more thoroughbred aircraft than the tipsy nipper. It's a very good forum, particularly in the aviation world, to offer insight into what can happen.
Can you take us through the video itself, please, Neil?
Of course. Watching the video, I have to say, I still have a little bit of trouble with, but initially a clearing turn. This is a bit that I always hate, where throttle back and start to pitch up into the stall. The mistake I made was using full aileron to help initiate the stall from a fully stalled condition with quite an aggressive rudder input. I knew the spin had gone flat very, very quickly. Within half a turn, I thought, this just doesn't look right. The nose attitude isn't as low as it should be, and the rate of rotation is different. And applied normal spin recovery technique. Made absolutely no difference. The tail group felt like they were actually disconnected from the controls. There's absolutely no aerodynamic loading at all. Absolutely no effect. I got some control loading on the ailerons themselves, and that was the only control surface I could got any feedback on. So I thought that would probably be the key to getting me out. And by using in-turn aileron, this is a spin to the right, in-turn aileron, what you're effectively doing is a down-going aileron produces some drag, which helps oppose the yaw of the aircraft. And that helped, along with forward stick, help the nose go down, the aircraft to roll into a normal erect spin, from which it was simplistic itself to recover from. It's just instinct.
How did you feel?
At that stage, incredibly disorientated. You cannot imagine just how disorientated. I couldn't read the instruments. Initially, just staying straight and level for a number of seconds was all I could really do. Once I'd got control of the aircraft back and a few of my senses back, scanned for somewhere to land out and turned into wind and spotted the area to land. The fact that somebody had erected a barbed wire fence that was invisible to me was the fly in the ointment.
What did you learn from the experience?
Proper spin entry is one thing. It was a mishandled spin entry by using full aileron to initiate the spin, which in this case I didn't need to do because it's from a fully stalled state.
What would be the one piece of advice you would give someone?
Be very aware of the fact that their aircraft will not always do what they anticipate. On this occasion, because I was entering the spin from a slightly different control input set, I added 500 feet, which I always do to anything new when I'm practicing. That 500 foot saved my life because I can only estimate, because I couldn't read the instruments, I came out of the maneuver at around about 500 to 700. And essentially, good training. Good training, I think, is the way to go. If you are going to aerobat an aircraft, you need to know about these corners of the flight envelope, which really you never know when you're going to enter.
The Aviators, for everyone who has ever gazed skywards.
For more information on today's segments, visit www.theaviators.tv.